Thank you, and I hadn't passed one bill yet. Campaign was long, a year, and a lot of different things happened, and we worked really hard because I wanted to work hard for you. So I was out one day, spent all day shaking hands, talking to people, and we were running our commercials. I hope you liked the commercials. We were positive. I hope you liked them. And so we were out and on the commercials, and this lady comes up to me, and she said, I love your commercials. I said, well, thank you, ma'am. She said, you're doing a great job. And I thought, well, finally, I got in a boat, you know. I mean, I've been out all day, and it's hot and sweaty, and laying somewhere else in the state. I said, thank you so much. She said, yeah, you're the best state treasurer we've ever had. So next year, she'll say, you're the best secretary of state we ever had. Whatever, I'm there. It's good to be with you, and I'll be brief as well. I appreciate Jason's remarks. We too are headed that way. I want to start by just telling you this last week, we have drags on our economy that are occurring. Sunday, I was in Parchman in Unit 29, and the issues that are ongoing there, you read them in the paper. Significant economic issues. I was mostly worried about our boys that worked there, our prisoners that worked there, Highway Patrol that was there. Unit 29 was partially destroyed, flooded, all the bedding and everything ripped up, and 30 prisoners injured, one died. Horrific scene we started Sunday off with. Those are things that we as a society need to have in place where we figure out who we are most concerned with being incarcerated and who we want to come back into your workforce. Now we're letting 5,000 to 7,000 of those people out a year. When I was at Secretary of State's office, I did a poll that we did, several of those, and you can see them on our website, but over 60% of Mississippi businesses, that be you, agreed that they would hire a nonviolent felon. I don't want them to learn violence when they're incarcerated. So to put that into perspective, 5,000, over the next 4 years, 5,000 people coming out would raise the labor participation rate by 1% in Mississippi. So it's an economic issue for me. So we have that. We have community mental health. We postponed the litigation that in December. Talked with the Attorney General. It was good to help us there. It comes up February the 15th. We'll be back in the middle of that, the community health issues that go along with that. I tell you that to tell you that we have issues that we need to, as a society, to decide that we're going to devote sufficient economics to make them work better. Obviously, there's litigation involved in at least one of them, probably in another one for much longer. But all of y'all recognize the fact that we have to devote some standards. I want to say one other thing about that. I go to these job fairs. I wanted to see how we were doing. I went to one that Whitfield had, the mental hospital had one of the booths up there, and they had sheets out for, they were trying to hire employees to come to work for them. So I picked up one of the sheets. It was titled Environmentalist One. That's the person that cleans up at Whitfield, and that's not necessarily some of those individuals are not necessarily the most sanitary conditions. Cleans up, does the laundry there. I asked what the starting compensation was. Do y'all want to guess? $7.87 an hour. Gross, not take home. So when we go to look, just as we're in competition with you for people. Governor Bryant, Philip Gunn, Tate Reeves have gotten the economy, and the President of the United States have gotten our economy to such a degree that we can't compete with you. At Parchman, for example, they need like 1,800 people. I think they have 749 people working there. You know, we can't compete with you. So when we go about the first part of this session and whatnot, I want to address to make sure that, first of all, you know me, I cut my budget every year you hired me for Secretary of State. I cut my budget, cut it last year. I turned back $1.5 million from my state budget last year. I watch the pennies. We're going to watch them again here. But we're not going to be penny wise and pound foolish about state employees anymore. We can't do that. You won't get what you need from state government if you call the Secretary of State's office and get somebody that's paid $7.87 an hour. So we are going to do that. Now, on the positive part, we're going to fund pre-K this year out of the Senate, and hopefully we're working with the South. I'm term limited, so they're probably not going to vote for me. But we're planting the seeds. When we start about education, you start when they're 4 years old, and we have a seamless education community that then exits at the time you are qualified to do the job you want to do. We're not a bunch of different fiefdoms. So we will aggregate those down, starting with pre-K. Our teachers are woefully undercompensated. And worst to you and to me, they're under-respected. You remember back in the old days when I did something wrong at school and I had to bring a note home to mom and dad, first thing they did after some amount of belting was to ask me what I had done wrong. Now, if we send a kid home, they want to know what the teacher did wrong. So, we'll see that these teachers that we want to retain, particularly in critical shortage places, those teachers are going to need your respect. They're going to need you to tell them how much you appreciate what they're doing. So we have this workforce development. Jason and I and the speaker are heavily involved in that and will be involved in that. I anticipate you will see many new proposals coming from both the House and the Senate on increasing our workforce development. Only 25% of our children are getting a college degree. That's the second lowest in the country. We need more college degrees, but the other 75% need a good paying job. And to do that, they're going to have great skills. Those skills will now start to accumulate not just at a community college, they will start in the 10th and 11th and 12th grade. You will see us push the 13th year of college into our high schools in Mississippi. Now, the last part of this is so important. The state government, and I was in the private sector for many years, ran my own company, ran my own firm. State government cannot answer all of the calls. Every time we have a tornado, just to give you an example, I'll go to these tornado sites and whatnot, and you'll see First Baptist Church of somewhere up on the roof, Catholic Church of somewhere else, Pentecostals are serving food. You'll see all these people come from all over to help people that are in trouble. MEMA does its part, we do our part, but we can't do it all. So what I'm going to ask each one of you is to just do one thing for one of our kids. Just one. Get them to shadow you. You're important. You're a leader. You're successful. They're going to look up to you. They may not have anybody else to look up to. You may be the very first one. Get involved in your schools. Give them your equipment. Give them a summer job. Tell that teacher how much you appreciate them. Go talk to them. Speak at their seminars. Have them out by your place. Anything you can do to just do one thing. If each of us just does one thing, we'll improve Mississippi exponentially. So I would ask you and ask the MEC, who is the leaders of business in Mississippi? You're the ones that we look to for statistical information, to workforce. What do y'all need? How can we help? We can only do so much. But as a group, we can do so much more if we just all do one more thing. So do one more thing, you'll feel better about yourself, and we'll feel better about our wonderful state. I am so looking forward to working with you in the future. They're gonna take me upstairs here and put me in a bigger office. I don't get the bathroom, I don't think. It's Jason. Jason got it. Dean Kirby is going to be an excellent asset to Mississippi. He is the senator's senator. We will name committee chairman on Friday morning, promptly at 10 o'clock. I and our staff have spent hundreds of hours looking at these committee chairmen. We look at them because of their abilities, which are very good. We've got a great group of young people coming, y'all. You're going to be really impressed with these people. Not only what their capabilities are, what their needs are, what they want to do, but what you need them to do. What does Mississippi need you to do? So you will see some that maybe are outside of the what you might have thought that that person would be heading that committee. It's because, in my judgment, which you hired me to do, that's the best person Mississippi needs today. So come on back after a Friday. We're going to start work promptly on Friday morning. I'm so appreciative of all MEC does for us. And thank you so much for having me today. Y'all work hard. We're looking forward to having a very prosperous new year.